Hi everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. This is Mike and today I've got a long-awaited set for you. Hated by many, loved by many as well. This is the 75230 Porg.
Alright, let's take a closer look at this little guy. But first, yep, that's what it does. People ask why it doesn't even exist. I have no idea, but LEGO made it. And probably similarly to Disney, making a lot of different porgs in plush toys and plastic whatnot, it was just a matter of time for a porg to appear as a LEGO set. I think they just smelled the success with the previous BB-8 buildable fig, and that was a really good set actually. Construction wise, I can tell you the porg is good as well. It's just the topic that many people seem to be not so happy about. We have set number 75230 inside the box. You will find 811 pieces. The price right now is not really official in the US, which is weird. The price at Euro is set at 70 euro. So I assume it's gonna be about 80, maybe even $90 in the US, with a $90 price being a bit too much if that really happens. This is a hard set to review for you guys. I'm just gonna give you my impression of it because the build is actually quite clever. I mean, it has a Technic structure inside. First two or three bags, you go really Technic on this guy. It has this function of the flapping wings and mouth, as you've seen in the beginning. It works pretty well, and that is because of the smooth Technic structure inside. I'm not sure if I can remove it. Maybe let's see if I can like take out a panel or something, maybe from the front to show you how it actually looks like. There you go. So it's basically a bunch of like those brackets, those square brackets of Technic. There is a main rod in the middle and it all moves together with the whole, let's call it spine, and along the wings or his arms and towards the red elements at the top, which actually portray the inside of his mouth. It's really clever. I think they made the same route as they did with the BB-8. BB-8 had the lighter function. And this one is a bit more complex because it's moving more than one part, but it works pretty well. And the only thing I don't like about this is that you cannot keep the mouth in open position. I mean, it always goes back, the weight of it, the way it's designed, it always goes back to the closed position because the wings go back and it just closes everything off. So you can't really have him on display in this shouting, you know, howling form, just in a closed way, which is okay and not okay. I mean, makes it work better, but for display purposes, it could have been some sort of a maybe lock mechanism in the back of the tail to maybe lock it in position so you can keep it open. You can easily modify it, that's not a problem. I just think it could have been included in the original set. So as you saw me taking that panel out, similarly to the BB-8, the Porg is built with panels that are quite well hidden next to each other. BB-8 was forming a ball of panels. This guy has a number of panels. The front one, as you see me taking out, is the belly. He has two panels under the wings. Those are also two separate panels. There are smaller panels covering the feathers on the back. I really like the surface of the feathers. They are using those Next Knights elements, those kind of claw elements from Next Knights in dark gray, and along with those one by one tiles in dark bluish gray and light bluish gray. Oh, there's some black one as well here. They actually form a very nice surface of those waterproof feathers like the porgs have living on the coast of Akto. I like this look. The contrast here is very well made with the white feathery front, with the dark feathery front on the wings and the back. And you can see, I think it has a very small detail of sand blue feathers. I think that's how they differed between male and female specimen of the porg population, with just different colors of feathers. I think that's a male then. Don't quote me on that, I'm not an expert on Akto fauna and flora knowledge. I'm not really an expert. The head itself is a bit wobbly because it's connected in a very specific way so that the mouth can move. So I don't really like the way it's wobbly. You can see, yeah, maybe, I don't know if that was intentional, but it's being held by one Technic axle inside, so that's why it's not studded in. But that allows for this angle, so the porg is looking right up at you. The build for the eyes is similar to the thing we had in the BB-8 build. And let me just Keep it open for a second so you can see what's inside the mouth. It's basically a bunch of red technic bricks to make up his tongue and sorts of things that he has inside the mouth. Yeah, those panels here as well also portray this, you know, orange detail of him. So that's a third color to contrast everything. And good to mention is that this set gives you a ton of those cornered slopes. You get a ton of red and left ones, right and left ones, sorry, that build up the shape of the head. You can see it's nicely moving to the back, so the shape is captured perfectly. I think this whole section here of the build is the best looking one by far because of all those slopes and the contrast of shapes with those Nexonites. I call them Nexonites claw pieces because they were mostly using Nexonites as far as I remember. Yeah, so after canceling Nexonites, I guess they had a nice way to use more of these pieces that probably would not fit in any other set. Basically, I can do this all day. The Porg is fun looking one in terms of like standing on your desk. You can take it for a walk. You can put it in his natural environment. Make him make a nest in your garden if you want. There's plenty of ways to do it, to have fun with this guy. And this pretty much answers who this set is for. For kids, right? Porgs were basically an addition to Last Jedi that was about to appeal to all the younger fans. Audience that is not usually the biggest watchers of Star Wars. So every show starting from, you know, Phantom Menace with Jar Jar, everybody's favorite, up to like Ewoks in The Return of the Jedi, up to the Porgs in The Last Jedi, there is sometimes and always, always a comic relief with some sort of a creature that is maybe misplaced or trying to be just a, you know, ease on the screen when it comes to events that are more epic in their grandeur. Porgs are just like fun things and kind of a fun interaction with Chewbacca, if you remember that set of scenes. So yeah, this guy is really appeal to younger audiences. I think that's what LEGO is looking for. And here is the biggest funny thing about this set, I guess. It comes with a plaque. Yes, so it's not a UCS. If I call it UCS, people will call me out on that. I called the BB-8 UCS because of that plaque. I'm gonna call Porg UCS, all right? Deal with it. It got a plaque, but you know, usually plaques come with mechanical builds or ships of sorts. Millennium Falcon, great plaque. You know the armament, you know the hull, the speed of the ship, Y-wing, Snowspeeder, you name it, all the UCS sets so far had a plaque because of technical details. BB-8 was a droid, so at least you can know about the droid's details. This plaque just tells you basically some National Geographic stuff about Acto and Porgs. So, home planet, Acto habitat, coastal cliffs, attributes, webbed feet, waterproof feathers, natural curiosity. Well, that almost got them extinct thanks to Chewie, and then diet, small fish. Color variety is gray, white, brown, and orange. I don't know what you guys think, but for me, it doesn't fit the set at all. They just gave it so it's like consistent with the BB-8 unit or other UCS sets. Let's say it's UCS, even though the box is just natural, normal Star Wars box. I still think it's a UCS display set. I'm gonna keep thinking that. Maybe they should make a new category for those buildable things, since when they introduced the Master Builder series with the Betrayal at Cloud City, they may actually get a new one for creatures and just things that are different from buildable figures and still are big Star Wars builds with a plaque, right? Yep, and comes with a Porg minifigure. Yeah, those guys appeared in the Acto training set as well. First they appeared in the Millennium Falcon, so that's the first time the world saw them. We had two in the Millennium Falcon. A cheap way to get them was the Acto training, or the Acto Island training set. And now, with this guy, you get one more. It's not different. It's the same guy that you get, you know, basically a simple parts and the print for that inverted cup piece with Porg's face. That's all it is. If you have a child in your home that has all the Porgs that Disney made so far, then probably for you, getting this guy from LEGO is a no-brainer. Otherwise, I had fun building it. It's a lot of technique. Some nice techniques used here. The body is becoming pork shape in a very nice fashion. So as you progress with the instructions, you just feel that you're building something nice. It actually feels good to put all those slopes in, and you know, this big guy becomes studless more and more as you progress. And once you put those guys in, the head becomes a really nice shape. So I'm not complaining about the quality of the build at all. I think they did a great job portraying this thing. It has some solid base to stand, actually. It needs this tile here. It's gonna lean back if you don't have this tile. So thanks to that, the feet and the tile holds this guy in a very stable way. It doesn't want to like lean forward or backward, so that's good. Feet, funny looking, but this guy is supposed to be funny. And again, the function is just, yeah. Okay, this is fun. Okay, I admit this is fun. I wish the wings were moving a bit forward more, but this is definitely fun. What do you guys think? The Porg, right? Are you gonna get it? Again, thank you LEGO for sending this guy to us. It was sent for us for review, so I appreciate it very much. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, definitely. I would love to hear from you. And of course, if you enjoy our content, you can leave a like, subscribe, and click that bell button to get notified when we make a new video. Thanks so much for watching, guys. It was Mike, and we'll see you next time on Brick Vault. Hey, thanks for watching this video. As always, you can leave a like and subscribe. And also, if you want to support our channel, you can head over to our web store at www.brickvault.toys. You can find awesome models there. All these guys that I have on the table are available in the forms of instructions and parts lists. Every purchase you make supports our channel and also the designers that are working with us on those amazing models. So consider doing that. Thanks so much. And it was Mike. I'll see you again on Brick Vault.